Good morning. Hope you have seen the first video which has been uploaded for class 7. So this is the second session for class 7. In the first video, I had shown you the difference between being intelligent and wise. As we know, intelligence can be acquired by having some books, going to the library, reading. Intelligence can be acquired. But becoming wise, that is very important in life. You may possess less qualification, but it is very important to be wise. Wisdom, with wisdom, many soft qualities come in you, and it is a very important thing to have soft qualities in life to become a good human being. That is kindness for others, love for others, understanding for others. All this comes through experience. So in this particular lesson, we will see that a particular king of certain country, he was disturbed by three questions in his life, and he decided to find the answers for these questions from many people, but he was truly dissatisfied. So he decided to go to a hermit whose wisdom was well known. Now let us look into the chapter. The thought came to a certain king that he would never fail if he knew three things. What are the three things he wanted to know? What is the right time to begin something? Which people should he listen to? What is the most important thing for him to do? So these three things became very important for him, and he decided that he should get answers for these questions. So what did he do next? The king therefore sent messengers throughout his kingdom, promising a large sum of money to anyone who would be able to answer these three questions. So the king thought first, then he thought that he requires assistance of some people. So he decided that he would give a big amount of money to the person who answers all those three questions. Many wise men came to the king, but they all answered his questions differently. So as you children know, we are all different. Any question may be given, but we have our viewpoint to it. So he got varied answers or different answers from the different people. In reply to the first question, some said the king must prepare a timetable and then follow it strictly. Only in this way, they said, he could do everything at its proper time. So do you remember the first question? What is the correct time to do something? So some people advised the king, sir, you make a proper timetable of everything, follow the timetable, automatically everything will happen in the right time. The others said it was impossible to decide in advance the same right time for doing something. So some people said that, sir, when things happen, we have to do it. There is no proper time, which condition we will be in certain period. So we have to do when we are in that situation or condition. There is no right time, sir. The king should notice all that was going on, avoid foolish pleasures, and always do whatever seemed necessary at that time. So some people told, sir, you should not involve in comforts, drinking and all other activities. You should be focused and you should notice what is going on. Automatically everything will happen at the right time. Yet others said that the king needed a council of wise men who would help him to act at the proper time. So some people had another answer. They told, sir, you keep some wise men with you. They will tell, sir, this is the right time to act. And you start acting, sir. They will every time keep telling you, sir, you are acting time now. This was because no man would find it impossible to decide correctly without help of others the right time for every action. So sir, you need a set of people who will continuously tell what is the right time to do this work or action. So you do it like that. So you hire or keep some council of people with you. But then the others said that there were some things which could be urgent. These things could not wait for the decision of the council. So when the some people said that when the council of people are not there, and if a decision is to be taken and it is not possible to call those people, it is very urgent. How to deal with that situation? So this council of minister people cannot help you. In order to decide the right time for doing something, it is necessary to look into the future, and only magicians could do that. The king therefore would have to go to magicians. So some other people, they told, sir, magicians, they can look into the future. So sir, you should not keep anybody, you should keep magicians, so that the magicians will look into your future and the action to be followed, so you can take the action immediately. In their second answer to the second question, some said the people most necessary to the king were his counselors. Others said priest. So now the second question. Children, do you remember the second question? Second question is that, who are the most necessary people for a king? So some people told that, sir, you are a king, so definitely your counselors or your advisors are the most important for you. Some people told that priest. Why, children, they must have told priest? Priests in the old time, if you remember our ancient period, everything people used to consult priest. They were the head, something like a head. They had a voice in the society. So some people told that priest can tell everything. A few others chose doctors. Sir, doctors are very necessary, sir. If health is wealth, so if you have good health, sir, then only you can have good rule, you can rule well. Yet others said that the soldiers were the most necessary. Some people told, sir, soldiers are very important. You are a very well-known VIP type of a person. You are the head of the country, sir. Your life is most precious. So the soldiers will be there, they will protect you. So that is the most important people you should always have. To the third question, some said that science, others chose fighting, and yet others religious worship. So the third question also, there were different answers to the third question also. Some said that, sir, science is the most important thing. Some told that, sir, we have a good country. We have to expand the country. So we have to keep waging or fighting wars with the neighbors, so that definitely our country gets a lot of annexed, or we, our country expands. And some others told, sir, every time you should involve yourself in havan, puja, or rather religious worship. As the answers to his questions were so different, the king was not satisfied, gave no reward. So he decided to seek the advice of a certain hermit who was widely known for this wisdom. So now the king was not at all satisfied to the answers which were given to all these three questions. So he decided that there is a very famous hermit. Hermit means a sadhu who lives in an ashram. So he thought that he is well known for this wisdom. And I have told you, in life, wisdom is more important. Intelligence can help us in some competitive exams or some other way, but wisdom remains with you. You should be wise. The hermit lived in a wood which he never left. He saw no one but simple people, and so the king put on ordinary clothes. But he reached the hermit's hut. The king left his horse with his bodyguard and went on alone. So now the very first quality, children, in life is simplicity. Of this hermit, wisdom, but he did not feel that I am something. So he never met some VIP or very high class people. He always loved to meet simple people. So he always saw simple people, that means those who were dressed simple and all. And the king understood that, so he gave up his royal clothes and put on ordinary clothes and decided to meet the hermit. As the king came near the hermit's hut, he saw the hermit digging the ground in front of his hut. He greeted the king and continued digging. So the king reached the hut. So this much wise man, but he is living far in the wood. Up now there is one word which has come as woods. Woods means jungle also, not the law of the wood and all. Here woods means jungle. So he is residing in a jungle and he is doing this work. He exchanges greetings with the king, but he was digging, he continues to dig. He greeted the king and continued digging. The hermit was old and weak, and as he worked, he breathed heavily. So the hermit was he was old, so when he was digging, he was having some breathing issues. But still he was doing this work. The king went up to the hermit and said, "I have come to you, wise hermit, to ask you to answer three questions. How can I learn to do the right thing at the right time? Who are the most important people I need most? And what affairs are the most important?" So the king went and told, "Sir, it is not a simple visit. I have three doubts. I have three questions in my mind. So I would like you to answer them." And he repeated the three questions. The questions are: how can we learn to do the right thing at the right time? Who are the most important people for him? And what affairs are the most important? The hermit listened to the king but did not speak. He went on digging. "You are tired," said the king. "Let me take the spade and work in your place." So the hermit listened to the three questions. "Okay, you have come for that." But he did not give an answer to the single question. And the king felt that this is the old man. He has breathing problem. So let me help. So he took up the spade. Spade, you understand? Yes? So spade means the tool which we use in the field. And he started to work instead of the hermit. "Thanks," said the hermit, giving the king his spade. And then he sat down on the ground. So the hermit was resting now. He decided to rest. When the king had dug two beds, he stopped and repeated his question. The hermit gave no answer but stood up, stretching out his hand for the spade, and said, "Now you rest and let me work." Now there is a bed, reference of the bed, and now we are sleeping in the house, so we know only one bed. But this is not that bed. This is the bed which we dig and create for the flowers to be grown. That is the reference. In the garden we have flower beds. That is the meaning. So again he asked and repeated the question. The king said, "Sir, please give me answer. I'll go back." So the hermit once again took up the spade and started to do the work. He said, "You must take rest." He said this to the king. But the king did not give him the spade and continued to dig. The king thought that I have more energy than this old man, so I should only dig. So he continued to dig. One hour passed, then another. The sun went down behind the trees, and at last the king stuck the spade into the ground and said, "I came to you, wise man, for an answer to my questions. If you can give me no answer, tell me so, and I will return." at last the king was a bit irritated. He said that if you know the answer, answer them, otherwise I'll go home. Here comes someone running, said the hermit. Now children, suddenly there is a change. Somebody is coming to the woods or the jungle towards them. Continue the story in the third session.